continue. Last time we were discussing about the trusses, right?
Yes.
And we discussed about the components of roof truss, and we started our discussion about component of bridge truss. Okay. So in this class we need to discuss about the component of bridge truss, as well as we need to discuss about determinacy and stability of truss. For me, it is going to be short, and we can start our next topic. Our discussion is about coplanar trusses. Okay, so our discussion is about coplanar trusses. So, what is the meaning of coplanar trusses? All the components of the truss, they are in one plane. Okay? Then it is called as coplanar truss. All the components of the truss are in one plane. Then it is called as coplanar truss. Now for the stability and determinacy of trusses, next discussion is about stability and determinacy of trusses. We discuss the stability as two parts, external stability and internal stability. For the trusses, right? We discussed it in two parts, external stability of truss and internal stability of truss. First, the external stability of truss means the reactions, the spore reactions are sufficient to maintain equilibrium the spore reactions are not concurrent. Spore reaction means
Not meeting at one point.
Yeah, the spore reaction, they are constraints, okay?
Yes.
The other word for the spore reaction, we use the constraint.
Yes.
So the spore reactions are not concurrent. Reactions. In pen, I can write constraints, right?
Yes.
Are not concurrent. Then the second part of the stability is internal stability. Okay. So the internal stability is, and then I am going to explain it by some examples. Internal stability of trusses. Internal stability means all the joints are connected by pin joints,
yeah,
and they form the shape of triangle. All the members are connected by pin joints, and form the
shape of triangle.
Now some examples of these cases. Now suppose we have this truss. Okay. What about its external stability? Is it stable?
Yes.
Because you can see it has 2 plus 1, 3 reactions. They are not concurrent, they are not parallel, right?
Yes.
So it is externally stable. What about internal stability?
Yes.
Yes, all the components are forming the shape of triangles, okay?
Yes.
So it is both internally and externally stable, right? So it is both externally and internally stable. Externally and internally stable. Okay. So next is we have another type of truss. What about this one? Is it stable?
No.
Right? So this is not a, it is internally
unstable.
Okay. Externally, okay, right? It
yes.
has been scored and roller scored. So this is internally unstable because we have missing element over here. It is forming shape of spheres. Okay? It is not forming the shape of triangles, right? So it is clear that it is internally
unstable.
Okay, another example. These are easy things, right? So it's not difficult at all. Okay, now another example is like this one. Now we have
Doctor?
Just a minute. Yes?
If it is internally unstable, is it affecting the stability of external?
So either it is externally unstable or internally unstable, it is one and the same thing. So overall it is unstable then. So overall instability, it is of two types. Either it is from internal instability or it is from external instability, right? So either it is external or internal, it's unstable. Finish. Now what about this one? This is stable or unstable?
Internally stable.
No. Internally stable. External not.
It is both externally stable and internally stable.
Yes.
Okay. You can see out how many reactions are there?
Three.
And they are not concurrent, not parallel, right?
Yes.
The internal shape, it is perfect triangle, right? So this is an example of both externally and internally stable, right? Both externally and internally stable. Okay, easy, right? So the overall story.
There is external rod, not in the truss. It's not internal rod stable.
Then it is not a truss. If load is not applied on the joint, then we will not say it as a truss. Okay. To be the truss, loads are applied to be the joint.
And this is the pillar. It's not truss.
This is not truss. Okay, it is not internally stable truss. Okay. So this one is both externally and internally stable. Okay. Now, when we consider the stability, right? To check the stability, right? So we use an equation, right? It is B plus R is equal to 2J. So we use this equation to check the stability, right? If B plus R, it is less than 2J, then what will happen? This gives you that your truss is unstable. So this formula, right, we use it to check the
stability.
The overall instability of the truss.
B R present for what?
Yes, I am going to write. So is used to check the overall or complete stability of a truss. Okay. So here what is B? Right? B is number of members, okay, B is number of members, R is
number of constraints,
number of spot reactions, and J is number of joints, including the spores, right? J, right? It is the number of
joints.
Joint.
Now, let's apply these conditions to this one, for example. Okay. Now, for this truss, again, another example, we have this truss, right? Now I want to check the overall stability, right?
Yes.
Okay. So what will be number B? So I have to check this,
right?
B plus M, right?
Yes.
So it is B is how much it is? Number of members, right? So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This is 12, this is
13.
Is it?
Yes.
So it has 13 members. So B is 13. Okay. What about R?
Three.
The spot reaction,
three.
They are 2 plus 1 equals to 3, and then J is equal to joint, okay? So joints will be over here. So this is one, first joint, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, and 8. So how many joints we have?
8 joints.
8, right? So number of joints are 8. Now compare B plus R and 2J, right? What is B? It is 13 plus
3.
3 and 2 into 2. So 16 is equal to
16.
So this is show
stable.
That overall it is statically, overall it is stable.
Internal and external. Right?
External, externally and internally,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
So if B plus R, if they are exactly equal, right, equal to 2J, this shows that your truss is stable. Okay. Basically, why I am multiplying J with 2? Can you guess? Why J is multiplied with 2?
Must be two unknowns at one joint.
Because at each joint, you have summation fx0, fyz, is it?
Yeah.
By the truss joint. At each joint, you apply summation fx0 and fyz. It means you have only these joints on which you can apply conditions of equilibrium. Then, how many unknowns are there? You need forces in each member, B, and you also need the reactions. If all these things can be determined from 2J, it's okay. Right? So this will be stable and determined. Okay, so now I am going to explain a little bit more about this formula, right? So B plus R and 2J. So finally, we get an idea from this discussion that if B plus R it is, okay, so this is discussion about stability, right? Now what about determinacy?
Three questions.
Also from here, the determinacy for the truss is, before going to this one.
This is a question.
Yes. So determinacy of the truss is, you know, again, the determinacy we discussed it in two parts. External determinacy, internal determinacy, and then the overall determinacy. Okay? So, determinacy has three parts, right? The external determinacy the internal determinacy overall, okay, so what is the external determinacy? The spot reactions can be determined by using conditions of equilibrium, right? The both reactions can be determined by using available conditions of equilibrium. Internal determinacy is, can you guess? The member forces can be determined by using condition of equilibrium, right? The member forces can be determined by using conditions of equilibrium.
These are two equations only, right?
Yes, at each joint we have two equations. Now what will be the overall determinacy? It is external determinacy plus internal determinacy, right? So external plus internal determinacy, it will give you the overall determinacy. Okay, now we must know what is external determinacy, what is internal determinacy, right? But by using this formula, V plus R, by comparing V plus R and 2J, we comment about overall stability and overall determinacy. Got it? By using this formula, right, this comparison, V plus R and 2J, we comment or we discuss about overall determinacy and overall stability. Now first case is, if V plus R, it is equal to 2J, okay? If V plus R exactly equal to 2J, like this case, then it is stable and determinate. Then it is both stable and determinate. It is stable and determinate. What is condition? Condition is
equal to,
you need to check the both reactions are not parallel. Okay? The reactions are not parallel, okay? So you need to check the constraints are proper. Constraints are proper and what else?
Concurrent.
No.
Not partial.
Proper means not parallel, not concurrent.
Yes.
Collectively we say it as
proper,
right? And members form the shape of triangles. So extra you need to check these things by yourself. You need to assure them. Okay? So and your condition is B plus R is equal to 2J. Okay. Then the second case is, if B plus R, it is greater than 2J, then what it will be? B plus R is members plus force reaction. They are more than two times the joint, okay? So it is indeterminate. Okay? Then your truss is indeterminate, okay? So
unstable.
No, not stable. It may be stable. Okay? So it will be, if this condition is there, right? Okay, then it is indeterminate and stable. And what will be the condition? Same, right?
Mm.
Can you guess? Same conditions, right?
That's
that
right.
The constraints are
proper
and form the shape of triangles, right? Constraints are proper and members form the shape of triangle. Okay, now last one. So B plus R, it is less than 2J. B plus r it is less than 2j, then it is clearly unstable case. Okay, if b plus r it is less than 2j, it is clearly
undeterminate also.
No, if it is unstable, no need to discuss about determinacy. Okay,
yes.
So this is only one condition, it is
unstable.
Trust. Okay, that's it. So overall, based on this discussion, we got these three important ideas, right? If b plus r, right, it is equal to or greater than or less than 2j, right? These are three possibilities, right? So if it is equal, then it is stable and determinate, provided the constraints are not parallel and it's form the shape of triangle, okay? Then b plus r greater than 2j, it is stable and indeterminate, but you need to check constraints are proper and members are forming shape of triangle. So this case directly unstable truss and finish. Okay, now let's practice it. Can you check, apply these conditions over here for this truss? Okay, now for this truss, what is the value of b for this truss? So remember 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 right, I think we did the same thing over there, is it? Yes. Okay, so what about j? They are 8, right? And r value it is 3. So it is b plus r, it is clearly equal to 3j, right? Stable and determinate. Constraints are not parallel, not concurrent, it forming shape of triangle, finish, right? Now let's come up this one. Now what is b? Number of members, right?
Yes.
So it is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 and 11. So b is 11. What about
g?
R it is 3. What about j? It is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, right?
Yes.
Now compare b plus r and
2j,
right? So what is b plus r for this case?
14.
B plus r, it is 11 plus
3,
right? And 2j is 2 into
8.
It is 16, and this one is so clearly less.
Unstable.
Okay, so it is unstable, directly unstable. Is it determinate or indeterminate?
No need to discuss.
No need to discuss, right? So it is clearly unstable. Now, can you apply this thing over here? Let's apply it over here. Now, what is the value of b? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So, b is 9. Okay. Then, what about j? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. J is 6. What about r? It is
3.
Okay. Now, b plus r and
2j.
2j. Okay. B is how much? It is 9 plus
3.
R is 3 and 2 into j is
6.
12 is equal to 12. So it is
stable and determinate.
It is determinate from here and it is stable because it is not, these are not concurrent, not parallel. Okay. Okay, so now a little bit more about these examples. For such type of questions in the exams, you need to be very careful about the joints. Okay, so sometimes two members are crossing one another, but it is not a joint. Okay, right. So only you need to consider where the members are connected, not the cross. Okay. For example, now I am going to give you another condition. Let's continue with the examples related to stability and determinacy of trusses. Now what about this one?
Unstable.
Distress is stable or unstable?
Unstable.
Unstable.
So there are two reasons. All these reactions they
That's
are
parallel. Yes.
Okay. And here the
no.
member is missing, right?
Yes.
So this is an unstable truss, both externally and internally. Is it?
Yes.
So it is an unstable. No need to even apply that formula, okay? So it is an unstable truss. Okay. So constraints are not proper and it is not forming the shape of triangle. Okay, next another example. The same one, okay. Now we have one roller over here, one pin over here, and okay, this one. And the joints are here, right? This is joint, this is joint, this is joint. This is joint, and this is joint, okay? This is joint, this is joint, this is joint, okay? So now what is this case?
Unstable.
Internally unstable.
Yes, internally unstable, but if you compare the B, R, and 2J, what is B value? Member, right?
Yeah.
It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, right?
Yeah.
And what is R? These are
3.
What about J? These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? Can you see it is B plus R?
2J.
It is equal to 2J because it is 16 and 16, is it?
Yes.
Right? So basically, it is this case. Okay. So it is stable and determinate if these, but these are conditions are not met, right?
Yes.
Because it is not forming the shape of triangles, okay? So it is
unstable.
Now, instead of writing another example over here, I am, because it is easy, right?
Yes.
I am adding one member over here and asking you now what is this case? Now, what is this case? Is it stable?
Second one.
Stable and determinate.
This is stable, right?
Yes.
Because now it's forming shape of. Now, how many members? One member is extra, right?
14.
Joints are same, is it?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Reactions are same. So it will be
17.
14 plus 3 and 2j, right?
Yes.
So what is 14 plus 3? It is 17. It is 2 into 8, it is 16. 17 is greater than. So it is indeterminate to. First, and it is internally indeterminate, is it? Because externally you can find these three unknown, right? But internally it is unstable to first, is it? So it's easy, right? Clear? Okay, so that's all about the discussion about the determinacy and stability. Next is about analysis of process. For analysis of process, we use two methods. One is by method of section, other is by method of
joints.
Okay. Next, our discussion. So this topic is over. Next is analysis of process. So, following are the two methods for the analysis of process. Analysis of process. Okay. So first one is by method of joint. And the next one is by method of
section.
So when we use method of joint, when we prefer method of section?
If you want to find the force to unwound member, we use method of section.
Yes. Now, if we need method, if we need forces in all members,
yes,
then we go for method of joint, right?
Joint, yes.
When we need the forces only in one or two members, right? Then we prefer to use method of section. And sometimes we combine the method of section and method of joint. Okay. So first we cut a section and find some forces, and then for the other forces we can use method of
joint.
And I just a reminder, I can tell you one thing, that this analysis part, okay, it is prerequisite for the design, is it? What is mutatallab? right? So it is prerequisite. So whenever you need to design first, you need to complete analysis. Okay. Now in your next design, for example, RC, there is a subject of RC, right?
Yes.
RC design, steel structure design, or if you are, when you will be studying, the, for example, indeterminate structures, over there, you will use all these things. No one will tell you. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you must be mastered of all these things at this stage. Okay? Okay, so let me stop this discussion over here. Tomorrow we will practice the method of joint, method of section, and let me finish our discussion about, we have 6-7 minutes, about the component of bridge structure. Do you have some idea why we need to discuss about different parts of the trusses? What's the reason behind it? Why we need to discuss the parts of the trusses? For example, purlin, roof sheet, sag rods, no, gusset plates. Why we need to discuss these things? Any idea?
This is
language of civil engineering. Okay? This is language. And you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Okay. So usually, the people, they, when I follow the I am saying the purlin, then I suppose that you are understanding what is meaning of purlin, where it is, what will be its design, what is its action, what is its use, right?
Yeah.
So when I say, for example, the bottom cord, okay, so then though you can understand what is meaning of bottom cord, right? Okay. Which type of forces are there? Okay. Similarly, if I ask that for some bridge, there is problem with the stringers. Then for an engineer, it's easy to understand where will be the stringers, right? It is under the deck, right?
Yes.
So you don't have to see on the trusses, is it? Clear?
Yes.
So this is like the language. So you must know this type of nomenclature, okay? So for the bridge truss, can you recall which component we discussed? So we started with deck. Obviously on the side we have two trusses, right?
Yes.
Then we have deck. What is deck? On which the vehicle moves. Is
yes,
it?
Yes.
Okay. So the under the deck, what it will be?
Stringers first.
Yes.
Stringers.
So our deck, it is resting on the stringers, right? And then
the
floor beams.
Stringers are rested on
floor beams.
And floor beams are connected with the
joint
of the truss.
Yes.
Okay. So this process is easy. Now the next one is about the bracings. Okay. So now only we need to discuss about the bracing. Okay. Sometimes we also discuss the trusses in 3D. Okay. Have you seen the 3D truss?
Yes.
Where?
Mysterium.
Yes. Where?
Mysterium, teacher. Stadium.
Stadium? Which stadium? Which one?
University Stadium.
King Park? I didn't know where there. Okay. Okay. So usually, for the, to cover the ground, okay, or the seating arrangement around the ground, usually over there we use the 3D trusses. Okay. Trusses in one direction and also in the other direction. 3D trusses are very common, okay? And these are over in this city, right? So I have seen the 3D trusses at many, many places, nearly in every school, right? So they need to cover the space, right? So over there on the top, right? So the shape is like this one, okay? This type of sheaves are connected side by side. Agree?
Yes.
Okay, you can understand. I will maybe make, we'll have some pictures for you for this one, okay? The 3D truss. Okay, so our discussion is about the bridge truss and its component. So we discussed this, and the panel is the distance from one floor beam to the next floor beam, means from one joint to the next joint. Now, we place this bracing, right? Can you see where this member is placed? This is known as portal bracing. Now, remaining discussion is about only bracing, right? Okay. And it is known as portal bracing. So where is it? Can you understand? So portal bracing is, truss is, to how many of you this shape is clear? These two members, this member and this member, they are basically giving us a portal bracing. Are you getting this?
The two of them create
a
portal.
Portal bracing. Its idea is, suppose we have one truss over here, like this one, okay? We have this truss, then what we'll do, and other truss will be here, right?
Yes.
Then we place one member over here, agreed?
Yeah.
So here will be another truss, right?
Yes.
And then we place this point with this one, okay, and this point over here, agreed?
Yes.
So this is in this part, right, on this inclined part,
mm-hmm.
or on the, if it is, for example, your truss is like this one, then on this part, your truss is like this one, agreed?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then the it is over here, exactly perpendicular to the truss, okay? So this is known as portal bracing. And it is very common in even in the steel structures. Okay, so we provide the portal bracing. This is known as portal bracing. Agreed? Okay. So this is portal bracing. And you see this member, they are, and this top one. This is basically collectively giving us the portal bracing. Okay. Then next is this one. This is sway bracing. Can you see over here what is happening?
Yeah.
So now from this joint, right? Okay, so we make a small truss over here, is it?
Mm.
Right? So this is one truss, this is another truss, right? So at the top, so in this direction, we put a small truss over here. What it will help us, how this small power truss over here will help us? It will not allow to move it in this direction, is it?
Yes.
On the top. So what is meaning of sway? You know sway?
Yes.
Sway is this motion.
Yes.
This motion is sway, right? So basically in the trusses, this motion in this direction, it is avoided if we connect these two top parts. So that's why this portion, can you see this small truss, right? This one, okay?
But we could use a beam, Duxo.
Sorry?
We could use only a beam to connect the both trusses.
Anything we can use, right? But usually we make this sway bracing also like a truss, small truss. Okay, so this is known as sway bracing. So two things are easy, right? One is portal bracing, other one is sway bracing. And then we use the top lateral bracing. The top lateral bracing, okay? So what is top lateral bracing? So this is our one truss, right? Okay. Then the other truss is over here, right? Okay. The other truss is here, okay? Are you agree? This is okay?
Yes.
Yes.
So what we do, we connect this point with this one, okay? This point with this one, this with this one, this with this one, this with this one. And then we make this type of truss at the end, on the top, okay?
Yes.
So this is known as this top one. It is known as top lateral bracing. So from the top, we are going to connect the members. So three types of bracing. Portal bracing, It is
so,
on the end, right?
Yes.
Here and here. So we are bracing in this direction, right?
Yes.
Then the top lateral bracing is over here. That's it. Other you know, right?
Yes.
So what else is there? Portal and port. Yeah, this, because this is the portal bracing, right? So we are putting the portal bracing over here. So that's why sometimes we call it as portal and post. Right? It's not so important, right? So you need to understand where we place the portal bracing, where we place the sway bracing, where we place the top lateral bracing. Okay?
Okay.
And other than that, these components. These are
the portal bracing, why we place it? Why?
Portal bracing.
Mm.
So your truss, this truss, right?
Mm.
It is very strong in this plate, is it? So this truss is very strong in this plate. But out of plane, its strength is very small. Even if there is some wind load.
But
from
you
here.
Already put sway bracing and top
yes,
internal
yes,
bracing.
Yes, yes. So all these, the top lateral bracing, the sway bracing, or portal bracing, their objective is same.
Oh.
Okay. They are going to give us strength in the out of plane strength. They are giving us. Okay. And these are very important. Understand?
Mm.
I can tell you one very simple quote, right? For the design of steel structures, in the design of steel structures, our main objective is to reduce the weight. Agreed?
Yes.
Because if the weight of this structure will be less,
cost will
then cost will be less.
Yes.
Is it? Right. But we don't save the money from the joint and from bracings. So from usually we do not try to save the money from the joints. So we do not make the lighter joints. Okay, we do not try to save the money from the joints. Okay, we don't want to save money from the bracings. Okay, because the cost is very small, but its effect is too much. Okay, clear?
From sway to sway, is it the panel?
From
sway to sway.
Sway to sway.
Yeah,
so this total is the sway bracing, the top one.
No, I mean from sway to sway, is it the panel?
We do not provide sway bracing at every point.
Uh-huh.
We provide, for example, for this one, if I am going to design, I will provide portal over here, portal over here. On the top, I am providing the top lateral bracing. Maybe over here, only at one point, I will provide the
sway
bracing. Okay? Sway is this motion, right?
Yes.
Sway and not.